Has this ever happened to you? Oh, cool. The IT department put up a new server where we're going to keep all of our DGN project files. Wait, does it have a new drive mapping? The classic server migration that breaks your DGN reference file links. Or maybe you've run into this. Dang, looks like we're going to have this project done just in time. Is the client cool with all the reference file levels being on in the submittal? Whoops. The last minute change to every reference in every sheet. If these are familiar to you, or you've run into any other arduous reference file tasks, then I've got a product you should see. This video is a brief overview of the Axiom product, RefManager. When you install any Axiom product, you end up with an Axiom pull-down menu, and you would load RefManager from that menu. And I've already got it loaded here. RefManager lets you solve just about any reference file issue. It does so many things that it's only realistic for me to show you a couple of the most popular features just to keep this video around 5 minutes. So far and away, the most used feature would be the option to batch process and change your reference file names or paths. And so that's what I'm going to show you today, at least first. And so here we have the references dialog box, and I've got some references there, as you can see. And look at the path there. I've got eProject RefManager references. They're all in the same place. So now what happens in the real world is people end up with new drives, new servers, whatever, and they need to move their references, well, all their files for that matter, their DGNs, to that other server. This tends to break links. So I'm going to show you how you can fix that easily. I'm just closing RefManager entirely, as you can see. And so here's what we have on the E drive. We're going to move the whole thing onto the F drive. And we're going to pop open MicroStation again. All right, so now you'll see our references are missing. And so we're going to use RefManager to solve just that. So you know what we did. The only thing that's changed is the drive letter, because the entire directory structure is the same still. So what we'll do is restore defaults, just so we're dealing with no extra settings that we don't know about or aren't seeing. And we're going to use the modify reference file attachments option. Reference location is fine. And we got to choose the component that we're going to change. You can see how many there actually are, but we're going to use the full path. But all we need is just the drive letter. So that will do just fine. And this location doesn't exist anymore. So we can just tab and it makes the new location. All right, here we go. Voila, all done. So that's the first thing, very easy to do. It'll do a heck of a lot more complex things than that. But just the drive letter is a very common one that comes up. The next thing I want to show you is how to basically toggle your level display on multiple references. Now, it would be in the same location, but before we get back into the modify section, let's go to our display. And you'll see here, we've got copyright. I'll just show you which one that is here, that little guy, and the next one down there in the bottom right. And if you look, both copyright and logo have level one turned on, and that's the one that's being used. So let's say for whatever reason at the end of a project, we needed to turn those off. So what we can do is, let me just close that right quick for visual purposes. We're gonna modify again. Actually, before we even do that, let's make sure we don't have anything set that'll mess things up. Now we're at zero. So we're gonna modify again now and go to level display. And here we can use this handy dandy select option to choose which levels we want to toggle. That's fine. And so since we're using view one, we got to tell it which view you want us to apply to. And so we're just going to turn off. And you can see there's a bunch of other things to do, but that's all we're doing for this example. So we'll close that and press start. And all done. You'll see we can come back just to show level one has been turned off. And you can do this for as many levels as you need on as many references as you need. or as many sheet files for your references. In fact, if you need to, you can go to a filter here and you can tell it which references to actually apply this to in case you don't want to process all of them. Maybe you only want to do a border file or something like that. Anyway, tons of options, extremely customizable. And there's just a world of goodness with references in here. But that's all I want to show you for this video. Otherwise, it's going to get super long. I hope it was helpful to you. Thanks very much for watching.